Hi, and welcome to another edition of Iron Strong. I'm Jeff Hauser, New England Senior Sales Representative. Today, I will outline the differences between ductile iron pipe, also known as DI pipe, and high-density polyethylene. This is a good topic for me to discuss, given my industry background, which includes working with and furnishing projects specified with HDPE during my time with distribution. Let me first point out that the decision is solely on the end user's shoulders, so I encourage you to gather all the necessary facts concerning different pipe materials before you make your final decision. Put simply, respect the differences and understand that selecting the appropriate pipeline material can have lasting effects on your operating budget and system longevity for generations to come. In comparing materials, you must first examine what design considerations guide the specifier in selecting the correct material for a given installation. Ductile iron pipe design is based on a three-prong approach, taking into consideration external earth load, which includes bending stress and barrel deflection, the live load a pipeline will be subjected to, traffic above the main, and the maximum internal pressure the pipeline is expected to encounter. The appropriate class of DI pipe is selected based on the worst case scenario of these three design criteria. Conversely, HDPE does not consider external load or live load in its design criteria. Only a defined pressure rating the selected pipe class is rated for. Essentially, HDPE puts the bulk of the external load carrying solely on the trench, which certainly adds to actual installation cost. Also be aware that HDPE does not consider a surge allowance present in any pipeline that has fluids change the speed, which occurs when opening or closing valves, whereas ductile iron pipe has 100 PSI surge allowance included in the design. The temperature to which pipeline materials are subjected can vary tremendously given the time of year and the area where the utility project is located. DI pipe can perform flawlessly at temperature ranges of minus 40 to plus 212 degrees, whereas HDPE has a design based on a single temperature of 73.4 degrees. How often is your pipeline subjected to a constant temperature of 73.4 degrees? Seriously. HDPE bases all its performance claims on a single temperature. The fact is, this product has an expansion contraction rate of 10 inches per 1,000 feet of pipeline with just a 10 degree change in temperature. In comparison, ductile iron pipe has an expansion contraction rate of 3/4 inch per 1,000 feet, which would typically be absorbed by the pipe joints. Pipeline ease of installation is another deciding factor when selecting what material best fits your project. While ductile iron pipe is suitable to be installed under a wide range of temperatures and job site conditions, with the use of a simple and effective push-on joint, HDPE relies on fusion, melting two 40-foot or 50-foot sections of pipe together under a strict regimen that can be time-consuming, adversely affected by weather conditions, and when subjected to tight job site confines, may hinder the ability to stage and fuse a minimum 80 to 100-foot section of pipe for the joining process. Another area to consider is the operating cost of a given pipeline. Size does matter when comparing products. That is best represented by demonstrating the inside diameter of ductile iron pipe versus HDPE. The facts are clear. Ductile iron pipe has a larger inside diameter than HDPE, allowing for a less restrictive flow as opposed to the smaller inside diameter of polyethylene, which causes flow restriction of up to 40% and adds pumping costs to convey water through the system. Typical flow comparisons of ductile iron pipe and HDPE dictate that polyethylene must be upsized when compared to ductile iron pipe to achieve the flow rate required by the project design. As stated at the start of this video, the specifier end user should do their due diligence and make an educated decision concerning selecting the correct pipeline material. You should not be reliant solely on material cost, but rather design considerations based on the pipeline application, all contributing costs related to accurate installation of the hose pipe, life expectancy of the line being put into service, environmental factors now and in the future, as well as the cost to operate and maintain the system. You'll find a link to a tip sheet in the video description where you can download a side-by-side real-world comparison between ductile iron pipe and HDPE. If you're considering which material is best choice for your pipeline, remember, ductile iron pipe has a long proven history of being the strongest, easiest to install, and most reliable product available. We'll provide communities with iron-strong service for generations to come. Thanks for watching, and remember to work hard, work smart, and work safe.